Joe Castello out in the pits looking for cool cars. You know, we found one. I don't know, this is going to blow your mind. Bob Mandell, brand new car, making its debut right here. 67 Chevy 2, but tell me about this ride. How long ago did you finish it, Bob?
Well, this car has been finished for a couple years. It was originally built as our bracket bomber slash top sportsman car. And we finally debuted it actually last week at Bowling Green in the Division III points there. And then we brought it to the U.S. Nationals. And it's just a really unique looking Chevy II. You really don't see them in top sportsmen hardly anymore. So we thought we'd step up and put one out there. And to have a 200 mile an hour Chevy II is pretty cool.
One of the coolest body styles of all time, and everybody loves them, but this one is unique in many ways. We know that you guys at ProFab do a lot of, I used to make OCD jokes, Bob, but I don't anymore because Howie Mandel is on TV telling me I shouldn't, and so I won't, with great respect. But man, the attention to detail is insane. Tell us about some of the details that you have put into this car.
Well, we started out, of course, you know, it's a 4130 chrome moly chassis car. And, you know, everything is fit to finish. A lot of people, when they look at our chassis cars, they look at how tight all the roll cage fits to the body configuration. And that's one of our perks in our cars. You don't see the 8-post bar sitting way over in the windshield area that you can't see around it. And when you open up the door, if you don't mind, I'll open up the door just so you can see in here. Some of the really cool stuff that we actually do is just a fit and finish and make the driver compartment as comfortable and clean as you can actually get in the car. So when you're sitting in it, you think you're sitting in your living room and having a good time.
Yeah, it is beautiful.
Like playing a video game.
Yeah. Tell us about the color. This is it's a bright orange, but there's a pearl into it that I wonder if hopefully people can see with the sun shimmering on it. But the paint outside, inside, throughout, what made you decide to go with this orange?
We're orange, you know, guys, as you know, with our 55s and stuff. This is house of color. It's a Tangelo orange with a extra pearl top coat to give it that really effect looking. Everybody that looks at it, it's like, you know, they're like, oh my God, is that tangerine or is it, you know, this or is that? But that's what gives it that that extra little deal. Jeff Hodgkins does all of our paint work on these cars, and he's outstanding when it comes to making them pop. You know, I always tell him, I said, it's up to you. I want this thing to bling when we're done. And this is what he came up with.
Now, I'm noticing the body line. There's a certain rake in the body line. Gives it an aero look. These Chevy 2s push a lot of air. It's not the most aerodynamic body style, but it looks like you've got some work in there to make it as aerodynamic as is possible.
You know, this is the first time that we ever took one of these bodies and gone over 200 mile an hour in it. And it was interesting to see how well this car really does handle. Last weekend we went 205 in it, and it drives like you're driving your pickup truck down the interstate. It drives like a dream. And we're really impressed. It don't have the long overhang like you see with some of the sloopy cars. It's a short little stubby 110 wheelbase, but you know, it's definitely impressive.
Can we see under the hood?
Yes, sir.
Let's do it. And this is going to blow your mind, guys. Of course, we feature all kinds of different machines on Attention in the Pits. But when one like this shows up at the track, we've got to crawl all over it. Bob, tell us what we're looking at here.
Well, you're looking at a rear Morrison 632 all-aluminum 12-degree motor. It's got three stages of nitrous on it. We used two here this weekend. It's nothing special, nothing trick. It's just all neatly stuffed in there and kind of makes it look like it's, you know, supposed to be in there. A lot of people look at the little 327 emblems I put on the fenders, and I tell them, I said, yeah, that's, you know, that gives it that character. This is half of a 327. The other half of 327.
There you go. And a lot of attention to detail under the hood as well. And it's just, to me, that's what attracts me. Like every line, the brake lines, everything is done and turned so perfectly. You must spend a lot of time.
Yeah, my boy Jeff, he does all the finish work. Bob does all the fit and finish, you know, throughout the whole car. When it comes back from paint, Jeff does all the wiring and plumbing, and that's what's really important to detail. When people look at these cool cars and you walk up on them, they see all the nice looking bracketry. Everything looks like it's supposed to be in its place, and that's what really specializes our cars out there. The, you know, the chrome moly firewall, everything's kind of rolled and stitch welded in, and everybody kind of just, wow, is that factory? Or, you know, they get so caught up in it, they're like, my car don't look like that, you know. But that's what really makes them unique.
Well, you said everything is in the place it's supposed to be. The place that you're supposed to be is in the cockpit of this race car. Can we see in there?
Yes, sir.
Come on in there. Bob Mandell, Bob's Pro Fab, hops in. Come on, folks. How much would you love to be inside that race car? I can tell you I would. Got the funny car cage. Looks very, very safe. Everything is perfect. It looks like a... It's got the new car smell, Bob.
Well, yeah, it doesn't. It definitely has a new car smell. Now, one of the cool features about our ProFab cars, this is a power switch inside the car. This here virtually turns all the power on. We wish that SFI would mandate these on all cars, but this is one of our primary safety issues, that the driver has all the control. You don't have to worry about somebody running up behind the back of the car. This is what's really unique on some of these cars. All this stuff, fit and finish, is right to your fingertips. It's a one-man race car. You know, you have your race pack, you have your purge, you got your barrel valve, you know, all this is right at your fingertips. So when you sit in these cars, it's just like, yep, I'm comfortable. You sitting in this car, you would sit there and go, wow, I could drive this baby.
Oh, you know I could, Bob. Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, and you don't offer it.
Yeah, don't offer it. That's what he says. Don't offer it too much, you know, but yeah. But, you know, we love our car. You want to hear it run?
Oh, man, you know how these shows end. Of course, you guys want to hear it run. I know you do. Fire it up.
This is a 632 single four-barrel nitrous motor coming to life.
Oh, that sounds so sweet, Bob. It is awesome. The car is amazing. And you know, the orange and the carbon fiber trim, like everybody's got to understand, you got the carbon fiber stripes, you got carbon fiber wheel tubs, you got these carbon fiber insets inside the car, the tunnel, on the roll bars, like that, that contrast between the orange and the carbon fiber just makes it. It is amazing.
Sets it on fire. It definitely sets it on fire. And then all the little bow tie, all the little bracketry that we make and put in these cars, you know, it's just like the little handle there to close the door. You know, you look at all the little features that makes it really comfy and you know, fit and finish.
Amazing. Well, Bob, thank you for sharing this car with us. We appreciate it. Every time you break out something new, we want to come check it out, and we love the fact that you shared it with us.
We appreciate you coming by and checking it out.
There you go. And folks, that's why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.